There is a specific term that Spanish literature attributed to that, and they call it the culteranismo. Okay, culteranismo, it's like culto or cultivated, and luteranismo. And not being technical about it, of course, you can always search what that means technically, but it simply says it's trying to say as little as possible with as many words and expression as you want. Okay, so it's like just like what we said, saying something that is ordinary and simple, but saying it in an, you know, an obsessed manner, in an exaggerated and extravagant manner. So trying to look good, trying to look educated. So that intentional use of words and expression to make things more difficult is what they call culteranismo in Spanish literature. The masses see literature as obsessive, unnecessary, and disillusioned, just like what we said. Barely understandable. Okay, so it's like saying literature in the Spanish Golden Age became pretentious, if you may, because they're trying to project a certain level of reasoning and intellect. But in doing so, they actually look more fake and extravagant in a negative way. Okay, so that is culteranismo. Now, an opposite of that, which is also seen as a counter idea in Spanish literature, is what they call conceptismo. Okay, conceptismo, of course, in English, can easily be understood as conceptism, okay, or, of course, the highlighting of the concept. Conceptismo is trying to say as much as possible in as little as you can. So, opposite of culteranismo, in culteranismo, you say something ordinary using big words, long phrases, exaggerated language. But as an opposite of that, in conceptismo, they are trying to say as many as possible in as little as you can. So it's like saying using one sentence but having several meanings. Conceptismo tries to make it more simple, but it actually can be interpreted in several ways. So several concepts can be attached to as little as a sentence or a phrase or a short statement. How many different meanings can you make in one statement is actually one of the things highlighted in conceptismo, okay? And alongside that, of course, there is mockery, satire, becoming a trend in literature. So compared to the chivalric and the pastoral themes present in the medieval period, the Spanish Golden Age actually is an experiment of expressing beyond what they grew up with.